Welcome back to Gundahar Tutorials. And today we will talk about a major topic in Oxygen Not Included and a major problem, which is heat. At one point you want mechanisms which delete basically heat. So this is one of the setups I use, and what does it do? We have this fluid which we want actually to cool down, for example your water supply for your base, plants, and so on. And we want to cool this down, for example, to like 15 degrees. So what we do, we pump it through another tank, for example here this oil, and the oil will serve as a tank with a cool fluid, like 5 degrees. So to get this fluid here to 5 degrees, we use the aquatuner mechanisms to basically pump in 42 degree warm crude oil and get out 28 degree cold crude oil, which then at one point gets this tank here to this low degree. And this is done by transferring the heat from the fluid to the aquatuner, and the aquatuner then transfers the heat further to, for example, this tank of water. And at one point this water will then reach 125 degree, at which point the steam turbine gets active and deletes this surplus of energy and surplus of heat and returns 95 degree water back into the tank. So this is basically the idea, which can be done, for example, for this huge amount of energy, 1,200, which is not that little, and also a bit of pump, of course. But yes, it's one of the mechanisms which really work well, and at my current play I use two of them, and they basically are enough to cool my whole base down to a nice degree of 20 degrees. So, how do we build it? So, we first start with the tanks, and we want the tank where we have the steam turbine on top of it with a size of 5 by 3. So we basically have 5 in here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and a height of 3. And then we have a second tank right next to it with a size of 6 by 3. So this is 6 and then a height of 3. Okay, perfect. Then we can continue with the aquatuner, and now we see that the output is like here. So we have the input on the left side and the output on the right side. Then we can use the pump on this position, use an insulated pipe, of course, so that nothing can go wrong. And what we now make with this pipes, we lay it down here. And for the out pipe, we position it like on the other side of this tank. And then we can use a liquid vent. So you have to be a bit careful about what aquatuner you use here, because they have different overheat temperatures. For example, the normal one with copper ore just goes up to 125 degrees, which is of course not enough to be activated. To be feasible, we could use, I guess, the first available material is like gold, which has then a +50 overheat temperature, which puts it up to 175, which is then high enough to support our circuit here. Then, of course, we have the steam turbine on top of it. So we can just place it like here and also in this direction, because if we have now the output on the upper right, we can now make in an S shape, the pipes go down. I highly doubt that you really need it to cool the machine by itself, but in any way you could do it, because if it outputs a degree with 95, you could probably, if the machine is close to overheat, to get a bit of feedback into the water. Of course, then the last part of it, we just put it like in here at this position. So now the fluid goes back into the tank and then gets reheated. Another important step, of course, is by laying down the pipe setup. For example, if we have then some tank over here, we have some tank, for example, here with the fluid, and then you have some pipe. Liquid pump. Then also, of course, for the first part, use insulated pipes. And then when you are in the tank here, you can then again use radiant liquid pipes. And then probably make it like in this setup here. Then we need here another bridge. And then we can go back out. And of course, don't forget that you start here with insulated pipes again. Otherwise, it will, well, fail to do whatever you want. So, this is now the pipe setup to cool this liquid which you have in this tank, for example. Let's put in here some water. And of course, you have also then here some water. Let's put it in too. And in this tank, you have oil. So you might wonder how to get probably oil in here. Well, you can just delete, for example, one of these tiles and then put a pump, one of these bottle empty on top of it and let it insert some oil. At one point, it will be full enough to function properly. Now we have two more comforting life choices, which has to do with the automation, and that is the thermosensor. We want to have one in this tank, of course, and hook it up with the pump so that we can activate only the pump if we are at a certain degree. So if we above, for example, let's take 4 degrees, which should be just fine. This pump is working and pumping oil through this aqua tuner and cooling it down. The same, of course, holds for your tank, which you then at the end want to cool down. You can also put down there one of these thermosensors, hook it up to your pump, and then set, for example, if you have it in more your main supply, you can put it down to, well, let's say 15 degrees or 20 degrees. And only if it's hotter than this, the pump will work and cool down the liquid. Another task which the setup can yield is a way to heat up some of your fluids. For example, I play now on Rhyme, and well, there's of course a lot of heat, but I want to farm some peppers for, well, better food. And so I have to heat up some room. And of course, this will be the hot one. So what you can do is to put down in here, for example, some liquid pipes. And I suggest just to use liquid pipes, maybe one or two segments of radiant liquid pipes, because it really gets hot. And you, if you pump water through here, you might end up to destroy these pipes and make a mess out of it. So try to avoid that. Of course, you have to think about this before you seal up this room, because at one point there will be quite hot steam in it, and then you won't want to open up this room again. So while building it, set up these pipes. They can be blank so far, but maybe at one point you want to heat something up, and then you're good to go with this little setup. And as I said, you can maybe two or three of these segments make into radiant pipes. Otherwise, the pump through liquid could be too warm, which is also then not good. So let's see, what does it do here? It already gets a bit hotter in here. Of course, this small period of time is not enough to heat this up to steam. But well, I could show you how it seems to be inactive. So, this is the setup I'm talked about. I have on my Rhyme World now two of these beauties running up and going. And I also said, don't use so many radiant pipes in your hot room because they might break at one point. But well, I'm now past beyond the point where I could open up this room, so well, I hope it doesn't get worse here. And if we look at the rooms, then we have here a cold one, we have here a hot one, and also on this side. And I basically pump all my water, which is in this tank here, through these two beauties, also through this room here a bit, and to cool all down all my water. And well, at one point where you have maybe this size of base, then you're quite good with the energy. I guess at the moment I use something like 7-8 kilowatts per second. But well, it has to be. So with that said, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if so, then please leave likes and please leave comments about what you want to know up to now. And maybe I can help and make a tutorial about it. So, not much to say anymore. See you in the next one. Ciao!